Hello, Krim is back. Thank you for joining me once more with this little episode of how I'm tuning my drums. It's always nice that you're part of it, watching my videos, sharing them, commenting them. So too much love from all of you. Thank you very much. I appreciate it a lot. So that's why I wanna give back some knowledge. And today's knowledge will be about tuning toms. Last time we had tuning the kick drum, but today we're gonna focus on toms. It's a little bit more tricky, but I will show you how to get a really nice tone out of your drum kit, out of your toms. And that's enough for the introduction talk, I must say, and we will jump right into the tuning process. Let's check out what do we need. Again, I would recommend you to use a soft mallet. If you want to have a normal stick sound, you can use the back of it, but definitely the softer part of the soft mallet will help you to listen closer to the overtones. Then we need a drum key again, and for a little help and reference, it would be good to use a pitch pipe app on your phone. Most important, of course, again, your ear. This is the most important part of tuning, and maybe it wouldn't be bad to have another drum chair or any chair with a blanket on it, so we can put the toms in front of us. It's nice and comfortable, and we can dampen always the bottom skin. I will put on some fresh Remo skins. I want to change all the heads on my toms, the better heads. They're nice and fresh. We got some vintage Emperor Clear tom skins. Let me get out the drill, change them real quick, and I will see you in a bit with the finger tightening process. Okay, I figured this might be important to show you, so that's why we skip a little bit the time lapse. I have changed already two toms, but let's do it together on the 12-inch one. So I have loosened all the screws, yeah? So we take off the old skin, make sure there's no dirt in there. Yep. And we're gonna get our new head. And that's what I wanted to show you. People do different things and have different methods. So we break a little bit the glue, you know? Like a guitar string. When you tune it up, you have to stretch it a little bit. So I'm pushing against this small part here where it goes down. I push against it so it will have this cracking sound. Don't be afraid, this is just the glue. Other people just push inside afterwards when you tuned it up. So we align the logo nicely. We're gonna put it back on there. And then I will use again my drill just to help me out. I'm not tuning it. I will not put any tension on the head. It's just to speed up the process because I don't wanna sit the whole day here, right? Just right before it will put tension on. Good. I will change the 16-inch floor tom once. And then we're going into fine tuning, and we will start with the 10-inch one. Let's do that. Good, so all the skins have been changed, but before we start with actually tuning, let me mention a couple important things. What is important for me in tuning toms? The most important is that the head is even, in my opinion. It's not about exactly what pitch you have. It's more, make sure that your skin is even and it's tuned in itself, and that the intervals, or let me say the distance between each tom sound-wise, yeah, the notes, that they are in a nice interval, in a nice melody. So for me, I will use a pitch pipe just like this pitch pipe app just to, in order to know in which area I am, but I will not tune it specifically on one note. Listen to the shell, listen to the drum. a pretty decent drum kit will tell you when it's the right tuning. For me, I will go for a lower tuning just so that the shell starts to sing, and when you are too low, you will hear this angry cat sound. If you're too high, you might choke the drum and you will not get its full potential. And of course, we want to check how is the tuning in relation to the other ones. I have four toms, so four toms with 2-inch difference, so 10, 12, 14, 16, but my two floor toms are a little bit lower, I mean by the depth, so they probably sound a bit lower, which is nice. And but before we start with tuning the upper head, we start with tuning the bottom. So it is a little bit different than with the kick drum, where I started with the better head. Now we start with the Razor head. I have here an Emperor clear. So I tune it all down. You will see and you will hear. So you have the wrinkles here and sounds dead as I will go and push a little bit on the hoop. All right. I have die-cast hoops. Die-cast hoops are a bit more sensitive in the tuning, so you have to be more careful when you make a twist than the regular, I think, triple flanged hoops are they called. So die-cast hoops are a little bit more sensitive in this matter. But I go again in a star pattern around and finger tighten them. And I can already hear there's a specific note happening right there. Let me try. We have a radio tone, but you also hear like some sort of a rattling sound. It's a bit too low yet, okay? But almost. So what I will do is I will just tune a little bit up. And there's this trick, don't always go up. Sometimes in order to match the lugs, you have to go down a bit and then try to tune up. And if two lugs are not in the same tone, you will have this interference happening and it sounds like wave. So whenever it's even and the tone will be the same, you have a nice sustain, right? So I want to be, now comes the pitch pipe app in there. I want to be around, I say around, a D for a 10-inch tom. We're close, we are in this area where I want to be. That's kind of even already, that's a good thing. So we will flip it around, it's already in the area of the tone I wanted to have, and this one is completely loose. That's a very thick skin, yeah. Emperors are always double ply, so this is what I prefer, and I prefer clear heads just to have more attack. And you will hear this little bit of cracking, that's just the glue, don't be afraid. I want that it really sits on there nice and firm, so I push down with, so making sure all the wrinkles are out there. Okay, and I will still push inside. You hear the crack? That's the glue. Very good. So now we try to tune it up. What I'm teaching you right now, by the way, is tuning in a studio environment where you have the time and it's quiet to tune. When I will be playing a festival or a show where it's a rental kit, the tuning will be really the last thing, because first I have to set up. And then very often it's just like, okay, are there any wrinkles? Let's get them out of there. Is it somehow sounding decent? Then I will go with this, or I put some tape on, but definitely will not sit like this because it is just too loud and there's not enough time. But we want to have a nice tuned drum kit for our practice room or for the studio, and then this works. So let me see where we are. It's still out there is some note, okay? Okay, now, hear that? That's the one note. Now I'm crushing it again and it went down, of course. Let me hear how this sounds. Not bad. Where am I? It's a bit low. A little tip, don't go too low with the first tom, because as you go down, it might be that your lowest floor tom won't be able to go that low in order to get this nice melody between them.
A few minutes later.
Yes. Gonna put it on there, and we're gonna also make sure that the tuning between the toms, like whenever there's another tom next to each other, it will definitely affect the tuning. So whenever they are mounted, we have to listen also if the sound is decent. That has a nice long sustain, and the tone around is. That's a C sharp. So that's a good start. I will continue with the 12 inch. For the 12 inch, I have started with the same procedure. I tuned first the Reso head. It's again an Ambassador Clear from Remo. I tune it up and try to even it out right now. Then we have this nice even tone. And it almost. Okay, and I want to get it in an area, let's say, whoop. Before we had some sort of a D-ish tone, now I want to have an A. So let me see. That's pretty much in a good place, and you hear there's a long sustain in the drum, and this is what I'm looking for. So don't be too crazy about like it has to be this specific pitch. Really make sure that all the screws and like all the tension is the same on the skin. So this one is loose again. We're gonna finger tighten them with this drum key and pushing down a little bit on the rim as we did before. Tighten them, finger tight. Finger tight, I mean I'm taking still. It's a drum key, yes, but instead of using my fingers up here, I have this little part on the drum key that makes it easier for me to get this finger tight tension. Push it inside a bit. Yes. Good. Probably still. Yes. Dead. Really dead. Okay. Let's tune it up slowly. There. That's the first note that it's happening. Let me see, where are we at? Okay, a little bit low still. The more often you tune drums, the better you get.
A few minutes later.
Let me see how it would be. On the drums. We'll let both of them sit a little bit so they can stretch even, and we might have to tweak them a little bit afterwards, but I'm kind of happy already. And we continue with the big ones, with the floor toms. Good, floor toms. Floor toms have to be low, obviously. And there's a little trick that you can also add inside of the drum. It's definitely not my trick, but it's a really nice feature. I hope you can see it, maybe on this camera. So here you have a cotton ball inside. A small cotton ball, each time you will hit the drum, then this guy will jump in the air and it will dampen a little bit the overtones and you have a bit of a more focused sound. It's a bit more difficult to tune low toms. because there's a lot of frequencies going on, and to make a clear note or hear the clear note is sometimes a bit tricky. I have tuned the Rezo skin again, but we will check it once more. Add an even note. So we are on a D sharp or B flat, E flat. So we're gonna flip it around. And in order to tune the upper skin, I will place my foot underneath the tom and just push slightly bit against the bottom head just to make sure that I only hear the upper head. Probably not the most comfortable way of tuning it, but it does work. So I have finger tightened the top as well to speed up a little bit the process. There's a good tone. Where are we at? It's pretty much an E. Cool. Good. So we have a nice tuning on there as well. Already here's a melody. Perfect. And the last one, 16-inch floor tom. Let's do it, and then we're gonna listen to all of them together, how they will sound. So, the last one in this game, the big boy, almost like a kick drum. But 16-inch is still okay. 18-inch is, for me, almost too low in order to get a really nice tone out of it. But this is a 16x16-inch floor tom. That means we got a bunch of low-end happening. That's for sure. So, of course, again, have tuned up our Rezo head and try to even it out. That's a nice even tuning. Let me see where we are with the app, pitch pipe app, just for a reference, you know? Definitely, I want to be lower than all the other toms. I want to be around the B, okay? As I said before. But this is a B flat. Sounds pretty nice and pretty even. Let's go again to the fresh, upper, better head that it's been finger tightened. Okay. Wrinkles, not good. That's like the Mario Gojira drum sound. Sometimes I wonder how he does tune his tom so low to get such a sound, but he must know. So sometimes this trick that I used on the kick drum is very convenient for tom tuning as well. Like, it gives you an indication in a way how is the tuning, like, sorry, how is the tension. This side here has no wrinkles when I apply pressure. On this side, they slightly pop up. You wouldn't see them if you wouldn't press inside, yeah? So, let me see. I'm gonna, again, mute with my toes a little bit. That sounds pretty nice to me. It does have the low end. We will try it out all together. And a good tip for recording If you want to create the same tone for every take, or you want to make sure that your drums are still in tune and haven't dropped in the tuning, record sample hits and then just play them back, and then you hit it right after and you will hear how the tone has shifted. That's a very easy and fast way in order to maintain a stable tuning. Alright, so I will put all the toms where they're supposed to be and I will give you a little sound example. Enjoy that, thank you very much for watching. Next part is gonna be about my snare drum.